In this video, we're going to talk about the five things that are going to make you wildly successful in B2B enterprise sales. Let's dig right in.
Welcome to the Million Dollar Deals YouTube channel. Our mission is to help you unlock your untapped potential and elevate your sales career to new heights. We're passionate about humanizing sales, fostering genuine connections, and empowering you to sell more and earn your true worth. Our channel offers expert insights, real-world experiences, and actionable advice on all aspects of B2B enterprise sales, including prospecting, negotiation, account management, and personal development. Join our community of sales professionals committed to continuous growth, collaboration, and achieving extraordinary success. Together, let's redefine the world of B2B enterprise sales, break through your barriers, and create a fulfilling career that aligns with your values and aspirations.
Now, these five things are conversion, activity, mindset, productivity, and optics. The reason that I've chosen these five things is really distilling the last almost two decades of experience in B2B enterprise sales, comparing my performance against my peers' performance, but also really looking at the things that I was doing to make me wildly successful. I also looked at what my peers were doing in order to understand the key behaviors and traits that were making them wildly successful. So in this video, I'm going to break down those five things. Now, before we get into these five things, it's really important to understand that these five things have been distilled looking at both successful experiences and unsuccessful experiences, because I'm a firm believer that you learn more from your failures than you do from your success. So whilst I'm going to be teaching you the things that are going to make you successful, the way that I'm going to do that is by pointing out the things that have made me unsuccessful and from my mistakes and the things that have hurt and the things that have left me licking my wounds for a period of time in order to help you elevate and drive greater sales performance so that you can earn more commissions and look after your family the way that I know you want to. Let's dive into the first one, conversion. Now, it's much harder to monitor conversion in a B2B enterprise sale, but the way that you can do this is take your average deal length, could be 6 months, could be 9 months, distill firstly the amount of conversations that you've had and monitor that against how many deals you've actually closed. See, depending on the industry and depending on the size of deal that you're selling, the average rep can't do more than roughly 9 large enterprise transactions per year. Now, if we're talking smaller transactions, then yes, the reps can do 50 to 100 transactions per year. So depending on your industry and depending on the product you sell, depends on how many deals you're actually aiming for per annum. The reason that it's important to measure conversion is because if you look at the Forbes research, we see that most reps don't actually spend their time on revenue generating activities. So we need to firstly understand and identify at what level we convert at so that we can start to use skills and tactics and psychological principles of persuasion in order to try to boost our sales conversion much higher. Now, in another video, I'll talk to you about how to convert using the psychological principles of persuasion. However, for this video, it's really important to really monitor your conversion rate. See, these five things, the CAMPO framework I call them, that we teach in our enterprise certification, are really important to understand because this is actually how you manage yourself. You can't wait for your sales manager to be breathing down your neck for more deals or more pipeline. You've got to take a proactive approach to actually building out your territory and getting deals on the table, building that pipeline and opportunity so that you can know that you can convert above your quota and so that you can make it to President's Club and so that you can be at the top of your game, which is, I know what you want to be doing. So let's measure that conversion together. And if you can get a better conversion, then you know that you don't have to work any harder in order to drive more revenue. The second component of the CAMPO framework is activity. Now, going back to that statistic about Forbes and saying that we don't spend time selling, we need to make sure that we have a great level of activity in our territory, because the way that your sales manager will measure you is through two things. If you have the results, they're going to leave you alone. If you don't have the results, they're going to look at your activity. So knowing that this type of management is coming down the pipeline, you've got to make sure that your activity is up to par. What I would recommend in the realm of B2B enterprise sales is that you're doing at least 7 to 10 customer meetings per week. The great reps I've seen can do 15 meetings per week. And if you're a BDR, then you're probably doing about 50 meetings per week. But the ultimate goal of all of this is to ensure that you've got enough activity in your territory to actually convert into pipeline, because then pipeline converts into closed opportunities. So unless we have that activity up the front, we're not going to be able to build enough pipeline. So we've got to make sure that we're keeping ourselves accountable every single week on the level of activity that we have from a sales perspective. Those customer meetings are so important to measure on a week-to-week basis. Keep them in a tracker so that you can see that last week you did 5, this week you did 6, this week you did 7, then you did 3, for instance. Then you can start to analyze what are the things that actually stopped me from getting in front of customers, because in this game of B2B enterprise sales, excuses are not accepted. You have to make sure that you've got the activity, which is the guiding principle for being able to build that pipeline, accelerate those deals, and ultimately close those deals. The third part of the Campo framework is mindset. I can't tell you how important it is to manage your own psychological space, to keep a growth mindset, to keep reading, to keep learning, to learn how to build emotional resilience, meaning that if something negative happens in your world, you don't ruminate on these negative things for 3 hours or 4 hours. You snap back into a positive emotional state within 5 seconds, within 10 seconds, so that you can get back to high performance. Now, if you're not in an emotional high-performance state, then that's going to impact your results, it's going to impact your activity, and therefore is going to impact the amount of deals that you do. So mindset is incredibly important for you to be able to get the conversion and get the activity on the table that you need in order to be wildly successful. And I have another video which talks specifically about mindset, but it's incredibly important to harness that positive mindset. Now, a lot of people confuse open mindset with growth mindset. That's not it at all. Growth mindset is seeing challenges as opportunity. My wife and I went for a hiking trail the other week. It was 4 kilometers and there were stairs the whole way, big stairs. And she had sore quads afterwards. And she said to me, "Don't you have sore quads?" And I said, "No, I don't have sore quads." And she said, "How is it that we did the same exercise track and you don't have sore quads?" And I said to her, "I'm a monster. That's why." So part of my mindset is I embrace the pain. I want the pain. I bring on the pain. I become pain so that I know that I can perform at a higher level. So when things get tough, I say to myself, I want the toughness. When things get hard, I want the difficulty, because that is what's going to help me grow to that next level and grow to that next level. So that's part of having that growth mindset, is ensuring that you see those challenges and those obstacles as beneficial to you. If you don't have the perspective that these things are beneficial to you and that they're harming you, then you are going to shrink into your shell. Your mindset is going to reduce. You're going to be less positive, less enthusiastic, and you're not going to perform as highly as someone that sees those challenges as growth. Someone that sees the no's as growth. Because let's face it, a career in enterprise sales means that you're facing with a lot of rejection. You're going to get more rejection than you do success. And so it's really important to build that mindset and manage that chatter that you have in your mind to ensure that you can maintain an optimally high performance state, and so that you can be much more successful. Number 4 is productivity. And I like to use this analogy. If we're building and constructing a huge building, would we be able to do that on paper? Would we be able to project manage that on paper? Managing all the logistics, all the wood that's coming in, all the glass that's coming in, the soil, the trucks, the painters, the electricians, all those sorts of things. Would we be able to manage them on paper? Or would we be more effective using project management tools online in order to orchestrate our lives? I can't tell you how many salespeople I've seen using pen and paper, and you can't architect a brilliant life on paper. You have to be able to move to software and taking notes on a notepad inside of your laptop or whatever it is, so that you can become more productive. The other thing that I like to do is oftentimes, every single day, I'll have strategic thinking time. And what I'll do is I'll start to think about things either horizontally or vertically. Horizontally meaning, what are the other aspects of things that I need to be doing in order to be successful? And vertically is, I might look at one deal and let's strategic think about what are the steps that I need to take in order to move this deal closer to a decision. So if we start to do that, not on paper, but we start to use software tools available to us to do that, then we become much more productive and we can architect a much more successful environment for us to be able to get more done. So if you were to compare a project manager that only used paper developer versus a project manager that used online software tools to manage their productivity, then the person that's using software will win all the time. So you've got to start to make a conscious effort right now to get off paper and get into online software tools so that you can become more productive and architect your incredible life that I know you want to live. Productivity is also about getting more done in less time. So go through the process of documenting your thoughts. Go to the process of documenting your frameworks. Go through the process of building step-by-step procedures for your sales process so that you make sure that you don't spend time looking for things all the time. So many times I see senior sales reps that spend 30 minutes looking for something that could have taken them 30 seconds to find if they had built a productivity system for their lives, an organization system for capturing their thoughts. Now, I teach a full system for this in my enterprise certification, and I don't have time to cover it in this particular video because I have a limited recording time. And the last component of the Camper framework is optics. This one came from licking my wounds. There was one time where a sales manager called us all in for account planning, and I was just frustrated with the whole process. I didn't want to have to do account planning. I wanted my sales manager to trust me to do what he employed me to do. And so therefore, I didn't put as much effort into the account planning as I could have. Now, one of the junior sales reps spent a lot of time on his account plan. He took himself off the field, he stopped selling, and he focused all of his energy on the account plan. Me, I focused my energy on building new pipeline, opening new opportunities, and closing more deals. And the person that looked more effective and more professional was the junior person who actually spent all this time on the account plan. So what I would encourage you to do is build a level of comfort with the planning and the paperwork that comes with B2B enterprise sales, because getting your management team or your CEO on the wrong side is not a good sustainable strategy for you. And I've been on the wrong side of that too many times in my career, where I've ended up in locking heads with my sales management or the leadership authority, because I just knew that getting out there in front of customers was more important than proving to someone that I'm actually doing my job. However, as I've developed in my career, I've learned that you've got to keep people on side, and sometimes you're just going to have to come off the field to do the planning and to do the account planning and to show that you know what you're doing. At the end of the day, these people are the ones that are paying you to do an effective job. And if you want to keep your sustainable high income career, then you've got to make sure that you keep your sales leadership on side. So optics is really the management of politics. And I learned this early in my career in terms of concepts, but didn't start implementing it until later into my career. I remember one senior account executive that I was working with in a sales meeting. He kind of slammed his book closed and he said, "I have to be a bloody good politician to work around here, don't I?" And he ended up getting moved on and his career didn't flourish. But this is the thing about enterprise sales, that you do have to have a level of political acumen. And so I've learned to make peace with that. It's part of one of the downsides of being a high performance person. You've got to manage optics, and that never changes actually. Even if you become the CEO of your company and you get investors, you need to keep your investors happy. In this type of career, there's always someone that you've got to placate and keep happy. So you've got to be able to manage the optics effectively, which is why O in the Campo framework is so important to me, because even if you're converting, even if you've got amazing activity, even if you've got the most positive mindset, even if you're the most productive person in the world, if you don't manage the optics, it can actually lead to disastrous consequences where you're out there looking for a new role, which is not where you want to be. You want to be able to go from strength to strength and make sure that you keep people on side so that you can get good referrals, and make sure that when you do get these new roles, that you have a track record of people that are willing to advocate for you. So guys, they're the five parts of the Campo framework, something that I've worked on for at least a year in terms of how to train and develop people with this methodology and keep them high performance and successful. I also have a Campo measurement framework that I use to assess people against those five key areas with five key questions in each area to show you with analytics and data where you're performing, to identify gaps in your performance so that you can increase to the next level. If you want that, I've got show notes down the bottom. Reach out to me and we'll do a free consultation with you to show you how to use the framework so that you can get the analytics behind your performance and it can show you deficiencies that you need to improve on in order to soar your performance. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and I can't wait to see you on the next one. Talk soon. Bye.